Europe has a vast and effective transport network, connecting its countries and cities for people and cargo. Railways are the backbone of its development. At its northern corner meet Finland and Estonia. Throughout their history, these two European countries have been growing strongly side by side. The two capitals are connected by ferry lines. This creates an infrastructure for cargo, tourism, and commuting. This link is one of the main drivers for the success story of both countries. Today, the Helsinki and Tallinn areas share a growing economy and market for people and businesses. 9 million passengers and 4 million tons of cargo move between the countries annually. Both cargo and passenger traffic are projected to grow in the following decades. In 2026, Rail Baltica will connect Tallinn to other Baltic countries, reaching all the way to Central Europe. However, the Gulf of Finland creates a bottleneck. The current ferry system is efficient, but long travel times still set limits for business growth and cross-border interaction. Even with fast ferries, it takes 2 hours to cross. This drastically limits the possibilities for daily working commutes or day tourism. For the following decades, we need a route that enables potential growth for Finland and Estonia and benefits the whole of Europe. Imagine if the travel time between central Helsinki to the city of Tallinn was cut to 30 minutes. The FinEst feasibility study introduces a plan to build a railway tunnel between Tallinn and Helsinki, connecting the country's railway networks for fast passenger travel and freight transport. With a fixed connection, Helsinki and Tallinn form a true, functional twin city metropolitan region. Fast trains open new possibilities for living, studying, working and tourism. People can easily travel between the two countries on a daily basis. This brings new jobs, new services and new business for both countries, within the Helsinki and Tallinn regions and beyond. It is estimated that together with ferries, the rail connection could create a significant increase in passenger traffic volume by 2050, totaling 23 million passengers per year. The amount of yearly cargo is projected to more than double to 8 million tons. This volume represents a considerable share of the total value of Finnish exports. Let's explore this in practice. Several existing projects were benchmarked. These and other similar projects provide data to better understand the feasibility of the FinEst Link project. The most viable tunnel alignment was determined studying various possible options. In Estonia, the route starts from Tallinn-Ülemiste, going underground in the Vimsi Peninsula. In Finland, tunnel stations are located at Helsinki City Centre, Pasila and Helsinki-Vantaa Airport. The tunnel surfaces north of the airport, totaling a length of 103 kilometers. Freight terminals and depots in both cities connect the tunnel line to the national train networks and Rail Baltica. Two artificial islands are created in shallows within the exclusive economic zones of Finland and Estonia to enable the construction of the tunnel. In Helsinki, the FinEst Link runs side by side with the Plan Airport rail line. It provides rail connections to all over Finland and further to northern Sweden and Russia. In Tallinn, passengers have direct access to the airport. The Ülemiste station is also connected with the national rail network and Rail Baltica, providing access all the way to Central Europe. At its deepest point, the tunnel runs at 215 meters under the sea surface. Under the Helsinki area and the Gulf of Finland, the tunnel runs in solid crystalline bedrock. In Estonia, the ground consists of softer sediments, such as Idiakara and blue clay, which posit different requirements to the construction of the tunnel. The construction is estimated to start in 2025, after 4 to 6 years of planning. The excavation starts from Helsinki towards the Upoluoto island by drilling and blasting. The resulting excavation waste is used to build the artificial islands in Upoluoto and Tallinnamatal. As bases for construction operations, they provide harbour services, material management, ventilation and energy supplies. In the Uppoluoto island, an inclined tunnel allows access with trucks. Due to geological conditions at the Tallinnametall island, the tunnel access is created with two vertical shafts. At these access points, large caves are excavated. They function as construction time hubs and evacuation safety havens when the tunnel is operational. Specialized tunnel boring machines are assembled in the caves. They enable fast progress and a safe, watertight tunnel structure. Several schemes were evaluated to find the most suitable for the tunnel. The proposed solution consists of two single-track running tubes and a maintenance tunnel between them. The maintenance tunnel houses tunnel equipment and is wide enough for vehicles to pass. It is drilled just ahead of the running tubes to examine the geological conditions. The tunnels are connected with cross passages. Every other passage connects the maintenance tunnel to the running tubes. These passages allow maintenance without disturbing train operations. Between them, emergency escape passages connect the running tubes directly, allowing rescue and evacuation. Additional safety havens are constructed between the two artificial islands and to the north of Uppoluoto. As the tunnel boring is completed, the machinery is disassembled, and the construction of railway equipment can begin. A one-year testing phase must be carried out successfully before the operation can start in 2040. The tunnel provides various transportation modes, which operate at different speeds and frequencies. The trains are scheduled to allow maximum passenger and cargo capacity even at daytimes. Per day, this can mean 40 passenger trains, 11 car shuttle trains, 17 truck shuttle trains, and 3 freight trains. The Finnish and Estonian rail gauges differ from the European standard. However, Rail Baltica will be constructed according to the European standard. To allow uninterrupted connection to Rail Baltica, the tunnel uses the European standard gauge. With an interoperable rail connection from Finland to Rail Baltica, the tunnel opens a gateway from the Arctic to Central Europe. Now let's do a breakdown. The investment cost of the tunnel is estimated to be 10.8 billion euros, of which 8.5 is due to construction of the tunnels, shafts and islands. Rail technology, utilities and material management add 2.6 billion. Planning, administration, investigations and environmental costs add 2.8 billion. This leads to a total cost of 16 billion euros. This cost estimate is a mean value, from a range of 13.8 to 20 billion. The wide range in the estimate is due to the unknown factors in the planning details and the technical concept. The investment cost has been compared to other European infrastructure projects. The low cost per kilometer is based on good geological conditions and high level of tunnel building expertise. There are several possible models for financing and implementation. With a 40% EU grant, the tunnel could be built as a public-private partnership project, where the Finnish and Estonian states would finance it for roughly 280 million euros annually during an operational period of 40 years. The income from the tunnel and train operation would clearly exceed the costs for train operation and maintenance costs on an annual basis. Emerging innovations and new technologies can also remarkably increase the technical and economic feasibility. The direct employment impact of the investment is estimated at 82,000 person years. By adding the indirect and compounding effects, this estimate rises to 159,000. Helsinki is already Europe's busiest passenger port. The tunnel connection cuts average door-to-door passenger travel time between Helsinki and Tallinn by over 2 hours. Daily travel between the cities becomes comparable to local train or metro rides. However, seen solely as a transport project, the tunnel is not profitable. The total economic benefits are 5 billion euros, and the discounted economic cost for the project is 11.2 billion. This results to a net benefit of minus 6.2 billion euros. The cost-benefit ratio is 0.45. In the sensitivity analysis, the cost ratio varies between 0.16 and 1.0. But from the regional development perspective, the tunnel is expected to result in much wider economic impacts. It opens new possibilities for people and businesses, as well as import and export industries. New services are created, as businesses can move goods much faster and get access to new markets and labour force. The economic impacts of agglomeration, labour supply, work relocation and competition total between 4.0 and 6.9 billion euros within the first 30 years of operation. The true benefit of the fast connection comes from bringing the capital regions closer together, forming a unified twin city, and from creating a core transport corridor from the far north to Central Europe and all the way to the Mediterranean Sea. Together, Helsinki and Tallinn will form a metropolitan area where the population and jobs are estimated to grow by 40% by 2050. The tunnel brings together the people and businesses in the 3 million people metropole, collaborating stronger than ever in education, digitalization, business and labour. The accelerated economic growth and uninterrupted connections will strengthen the trade, business and labour market in the whole of Finland and Estonia. This improves their competitiveness, especially towards the Mediterranean, the Black Sea and Asia. For the whole of the EU, this offers a new gateway to the Arctic. Helsinki and Tallinn are the focal point of this increased traffic and economic growth. Improved international accessibility to this vibrant twin city boosts the attractiveness of the whole region. Together and connected, Finland and Estonia form a new, strong, magnetic north for the Europe of the future.